Siyempre na yung ating first runner up ay walang iba, candidate number 10.
Yes! Congratulations! Okay, your question is, what would heterosexual kid learn from LGBT community? Once again, what would heterosexual kid learn from LGBT community? Your timer starts now.
One lesson that the heterosexual community can learn from the LGBT is that we are brave. We are courageous. Every time we step out of the door, discrimination has always been there. Our gender identity is a big question to the society. And we became and we choose to be brave because we do not have any choice. That choice is for us to live freely, for us to express our emotions and gender identity. Heterosexual community is very lucky that they do not need to come out of their shell. But us in the LGBT community, we are confined. We are so discriminated by our gender alone. How much more with our ability to do our job, to express our liberty to love. And with that, bravery is something that they can learn from us. Because ever since I became a transgender woman, I choose to be courageous. To chase after my dreams. Thank you so much. Good evening.
Very well said, Kelly. Number 4. Tindihan mo yun?
Sabog talaga.
Matalino yun po. Yes!
Laro.
Busog ka na ba?
Ayan, candidate number 7, baka may gusto kong pasalamatan at this moment of time dahil nakapasok ka sa ating top 5.
Well, I'd like to thank my team. Thank you so much for making me beautiful tonight. And of course, to the people who's been supporting me from the very beginning of my pageant career. And thank you so much, people of Marikina, for a very welcome love and the support for the LGBTQIA+ community.
Thank you. So and much. This time, this is your question, candidate number 7. How can you balance the responsibilities that comes with the title with other personal obligations? Once again, how can you balance the responsibilities that come with the title with other personal obligation? Your timer starts now.
Thank you so much for that very wonderful question. Well, I am joining trans pageantry not just to show my physical appearance to other people or not just to show up that I am beautiful physically, but I am joining trans pageantry because I have advocacies to tell to the people. And one of that is to end the violations against women and children. It is one of my responsibility and obligation to fight for the right of women and children because I've experienced it from the past when my mom has experienced a lot of trauma and causes from my dad. And so that growing up, I'd like to fight for this right as my responsibility, not just in my personal life, but also to show to the people using this stage because, you know, having a crown is not just a crown, but having a crown is also as a responsibility. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, candidate number 7.
Sabay kayo.
Okay, candidate number 8. This is your question. How can you describe the colors of the rainbow into a blind child? Once again, how can you describe the colors of the rainbow into a blind child?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the mere fact that rainbow signifies the LGBT community, simply I will take the blind child in this kind of show, listening, entertaining, and having fun, and as well as having educated. Why? Because those blind persons can easily adopt by even blind, by hearing something, they can easily adapt how they understand rainbow. Because rainbow signifies the LGBT community. Because LGBT community gives happiness in this world, whether you like it or not. Like this tonight, you are listening, you're watching, and you're having fun and being educated because of us, member of LGBT. Thank you.
Once again, palapakan natin, Kennedy, number 8.
Fairness, ang ganda. Tama. Take your question, Kennedy, okay. Number 10.
Good morning, honorable panel. I'm grateful to be here. Thank you.
Okay, candidate number 10. This is your question. Are you ready not to win the crown? Once again, are you ready not to win the crown?
For the information of the general public, I am already 47 years old. I started joining pageant when I was 13 years old. If I'm not ready to win pageant, I have, not to brag, and with all humility, I have thousands of crowns of won already. If I'm not, the question, if I'm not ready to win, why not? Because not all things should be given to you at all time. Know that selfless love is very important, because being a beauty queen, I won't be able to understand what winning is all about if you do not know the meaning of losing and not winning for that fight. So definitely I have to say, this pageant, whoever it is, it's like a ball game. You win or you lose. Once and for all, the legacy that I have led to everyone, that sharing, giving, and camaraderie and sportsmanship is the most vital thing why pageant is made. Thank you.
Thank you so much, candidate number 10.
Ang ganda ng gown, bidin.
Okay, candidate number 12, this is your final question. What is the importance of beauty pageant in today's world?
In my opinion, the most important role of beauty pageants right now is not just only for us to showcase how beautiful we are, but it's, of course, it's all about our advocacies. My advocacies for all young generation right now is to be brave. Do not be afraid to try as a beginner. To tell you honestly, I'm a beginner to compete with this kind of prestigious pageant. And as you can see, there's a lot of legendary contestants, but I'm not afraid to compete with them. And I think this is the one thing that I would love to leave a lesson for the young generation. So do not hesitate, do not afraid to try to join this kind of pageant. That is the simplest answer that comes from my heart. Thank you and good evening.
Very well said, candidate number 12. And done. With an average score of 81.3%. Congratulations to candidate number 8. And you will receive a sash, a crown, and an ABGG products, a bouquet, a certificate, a cash, and that's all.
Thank you. I am brought up tayo together with asking ikaw at Pita Angelo Rodriguez and Secretary Pita Carden asking Chairman of Warloo Panel.
One runner up to name one time.
We're going to announce our third third place, may we call in Sir Yvest Award, our third place? And she will receive 3,000 pesos cash. Tama ba ako? Tama, 3,000. With an average score of 88.42%. Our third runner-up is none other than candidate number... Candidate number 7. Alam mo tong tatlong to, magkakadikit yung ano nila, score.
Talagang dikitan talaga yung ano nila.
Point lang.
Point lang.
Tsaka may point. We're going to announce our second place.
To be awarded by ang ating isang hurado, Ms. Christina Hinunangan.
And our second place will receive 5,000 pesos cash, a sash, a crown, a bouquet, certificate, and AGBB products.
And the SK Kagawad to be awarded by SK Kagawad at Salina.
And welcome to Star City. Kami yung background.
Patay na sa akin ng Star City.
Our second runner-up with an average score of 19.2%. This year's second runner-up is none other than candidate number four.
Pantaw muna po tayo.
And ang una kong babangkitin
ay syempre ang ating
sa magiging Queen of Doña Petra 2020.
Ayan, inibitahan po muna si ating candidate number 10 at candidate number 12. Dito tayo sa gitna.
Our Queen of Doña Petra 2023 will receive 15,000 pesos cash,
a cash,
a sash, a bouquet, a crown.
And syempre meron tayong worth 2,000 gift check para sa ating Burgalicious of
Mine. Yes.
At syempre ang tatanghalin natin, Queen of Doña Petra first runner-up ay magkakamit ng
10,000 pesos cash,
a bouquet, a sash, a crown.
And
to be awarded by Honorable Cifret Ancheta. And Honorable, syempre ang ating judge, Honorable Jessica Soriano and Mr. Jano Michael Rodriguez.
Yes.
Ayan sa ating unang babanggitin ni Ms. Rica, ang ating Queen of Doña Petra 2023.
With an average score of 91.8%.
Syempre ang ating first runner-up ay nakakuha ng
90.2%. I'm sorry.
90.74%.
Once again, this year, Queen of Doña Petra 2023, sino ang bet niyong manalo? Maraming salamat po muli sa lahat ng dumalo sa kasayahan ngayong gabi. At magkita-kita po ulit bukas ng gabi.
Mamaya na.
Mamayang gabi.
Alas 7 ng gabi sa ating Queen. Queen pala.
Got Talent.
Got Talent. Doña Petra, Got Talent.
Okay, hindi na po natin patatagalin po, ladies and gentlemen, our queen of Doña Petra 2023 with an average score of 91.8% is none other than candidate number 12.
Siya pa rin ating personal apay, walang iba, candidate number 10.
Yes! Congratulations! Congratulations to all the winners. Once again, our Queen of Doña Petra 2023 is candidate number 12.
Ayan, once again, palapakan naman po natin ang ating mga limang nanalo.
And of course, our first runner-up is candidate number 10. Congratulations to all the winners. Maraming salamat po for staying with us. Thank you so much, everybody.
Kita-kita po tayo mamaya.